A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That was how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean Sea. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. We're on the French Riviera once more this weekend at the 2-mile-long Circuit de Monaco. The cars climb around 40 metres up through Beau Rivage, onto the casino, and then descending down towards the harbour through Sector 2. It's a very short run from pole position to the first of the 19 corners here, 7 to the left and 11 to the right. There's one single DRS zone as well, so don't expect that to make overtaking any easier today. And as the drivers start thinking about getting a good start and how on earth to get through Sandovot in one piece, I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, if we might be seeing a safety car or two today.
Well, you wouldn't exactly bet against it, would you? Statistically, it is pretty common, of course. About 80% of all Monaco Grand Prix will have at least one safety car. And that's despite the incredible work of the marshals around here, who you'll often see lifting cars out of the way just under the yellow flag conditions. The teams will always plan for the worst-case scenario, though, and they'll be making sure various caution periods are built into their strategy models for the race.
Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks for today's race. Joker lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Butler, Lucas Faber, and Ricciardo, Leclerc, Magnussen, Albon, and Pierre Gasly. Kvyat, Vettel, they've taken a grid penalty. Kimi Raikkonen, and Sainz, Hülkenberg, Perez, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Lando Norris. Kubica and George Russell ends our grid lineup, and with lights out, just moment.
Oh,
Ferrari have really pulled it out of the bag today. It's a great win. Anthony Davidson, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, I think it was clear what the main contributing factor out on the track was today, speed. I know it sounds like an obvious thing to say, Crofty, but fast cars win races, and we saw that today with our winner.
Ferrari are at it again, an excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Joker increases the championship lead. Some amazing talents out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
Driving.